straight into today's top stories. And a Melbourne strip club has handed Lidia Thorpe a lifetime ban following an incident outside the venue on Sunday. The independent senator was filmed verbally abusing a group of men on the street around 3 a.m. Lidia claims the men provoked her as she left the club. However, her parliamentary colleagues are not impressed. Jackie Lambie says Lidia must take responsibility for her actions.
If you do not think you're in a good way, then go and do what the rest of us do and go and get some counselling or psychology because, quite frankly, something needs to be done. But I would say this to Lidia, you cannot keep doing this.
A lifeline for some Port of Davis customers, another builder will complete up to 375 unfinished townhouses. Liquidators have signed a deal with the Nostra Property Group, which also includes employment for 16 Port of Davis staff. Construction on 169 of the 375 properties Nostra has agreed to complete has not yet started. The Port of Davis collapse left around 1,700 homes in limbo across Victoria and Queensland. And a massive day for Neighbours fans. Filming has resumed on the much-loved TV soap, heralding the return of longtime faves like Toadie to Ramsay Street. The show was cancelled in March last year after 37 years on air. Almost 1.5 million Aussies tuned in for the final episode, numbers that helped convince Amazon to finance the show for a new era. And our favourite, Ryan Toadie Maloney, joins us now.
Hey, guys. How are you going?
Fabulous. How are you? Neighbours is back. What was the vibe like on set?
Oh, it was amazing. Everyone was just really, really excited. I mean, when Neighbours finished, it was almost like we all went to the wrong funeral in that, you know, we all turned up and all got really, really sad. And then we went, hang on a second, this is the wrong place. We're still alive. It's good. We're here.
But also, excellent way to get another finale down the track. So well done you. Hey, so the finale was great, by the way, last year. And it ended with you deciding to stay in Ramsay Street and then there was this big street party. So does the new series begin the day after when everyone has a hangover? Like, how do you start it?
It's post-apocalyptic is when we start. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of zombies coming in and all that kind of stuff. We're on Amazon now, so, you know, we've got to spice things up a bit, yeah.
Wow. Ryan, did you have to do much to reconnect with the character of Toadie, or do you think at this point in your life you are more Toadie than Ryan?
Well, after 28 years, yeah, I can just kind of slide right back into him. Yeah. Although, you know, I do kind of feel like, you know, I've had, like, my own kind of army kind of thing happening. I was growing my hair really long and then I had to shave it all off this morning. So, you know.
Oh, wow.
It's like Elvis goes to the army.
Why couldn't Toadie come back with long hair? Like, he had a bit of a holiday and then he's back.
Well, if we went back in time and we grew the mullet back, you know, there's fingers crossed, you know, hey?
Yeah. you must be glad you didn't leave in the last episode because you were about to go, but thank God you stayed.
I know. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here.
That's how it works.
Sorry. Did you have to pull that confused face after you said, otherwise I wouldn't? It looks like you were regretting it for a second there.
No, I'm not regretting this at all. This is actually really exciting because we've got a whole bunch of new players as well. So, today, you know, you said, you know, kind of how was today? Well, today I spent pretty much most of it kind of helping new actors, you know, basically around the set and helping them out with their acting and, you know, just the general stuff of, you know, where to stand on set.
Ryan, this is a huge global success, Neighbours. You've just been in the UK doing some live shows. Give us an idea of how that was.
Well, I think we were kind of like geriatric rock stars, really. we had 15 shows around the UK in which they all sold out. We're talking 2,000-3,000, you know, seat venues. The London Palladium we actually sold out faster than any other show. It was absolutely huge. Yeah, and that's, you know, we really got the vibe of why the outpouring of grief that people had that it was wrapping up. And that's why Amazon actually took us on, is because they went, look, if people are really like this invested in the show, well, then we have to have this show.
Well, grief no more. Ryan, thank you so much for stopping by. We're so glad it's back.
Beautiful. Thanks for having me. And here's to many more episodes.
Yes.
Many more finales.
Yes. Well, to other news now, and Woolworths has started phasing out its reusable 15-cent plastic bags at supermarkets in Victoria, Tasmania and New South Wales. The change starts today. The rundown of stock should take about 2 months. The bags have already been removed from stores in other states and territories. And better be careful how you talk to Alexa and Siri around your kids. New research has found children strongly feel AI tech shouldn't be yelled at or harmed. That's because they believe the voice assistants have emotions, feelings and a mind of their own, even though they don't have a body. Mm. One 10-year-old reported it was not okay to yell at Alexa because it might get upset or feel sad. And I feel like this story is really connecting with Pricey. You wouldn't yell at Alexa, would you?
If I had any of those things, I think I'd be very polite. That's children. What is it, Alexi and Siri?
Alexi? Yeah. I haven't used Alexi, but maybe I'll look that one up.
What's it called?
Alexa. Oh, yeah. I don't buy into this at all, because if Alexa had feelings, she would say, I love you back when I say it to her.
But also, who's yelling at Alexa?
Yeah, well...
Who's yelling at Alexa and Siri?
Because don't you get frustrated when you ask it a thing and it doesn't give you the answer you want?
No, I say, do not worry. Thank you for your efforts, because when they take over the world, I will be safe.
I know what you mean. This is why I feel like you have to put a phone cover on your phone, because when you, if you drop it without one now... And then in the future, they'll remember that and they'll be like, you didn't look after
us. Oh, so when AI is sentient, they'll say, where are all the phone droppers? Line them up against
and then they're going to kill us all.
And I'll be fine.
You'll be fine, Tony.
Shut up.
I love you, Pricey.
That's not how he speaks to Alexa.
No.
And here's something Melburnians can brag about. Melbourne is officially bigger than Sydney after an update to its geographical boundary. The city's significant urban area was changed to include the northwestern district of Melton. That's lifted the city's population to 4,875,400. That's 18,700 more than Sydney. And Greater Melbourne's population is also predicted to overtake that of Greater Sydney by 2031-32, but Greater Melbourne isn't even... if it's already below Sydney, why is this count? Like, this is such a...
Well, my favourite Melbourne suburb is Adelaide. So that's why... That's how we got over the line.
That's why it's encroaching.
Yeah.
Why does anyone want to celebrate this, though? Why would you? Just means you're going to spend the rest of the time in your car on a freeway, clogged up in traffic, won't be able to get a train. I mean, bigger's not better.
Mate, you won't be doing any of those things.
Oh, you're just going to get
you're going to get in your chopper and just get
I just find this whole thing ridiculous.
It is a bit strange.
But it's just bragging.
But Sydney might as well just add Wollongong and then they're in front.
I find that Melbourne brags a lot. No offence, Melbourne, but brag a lot.
What?
About things. About, especially if it's a war between Melbourne and Sydney.
Yeah.
Sydney doesn't care.
Can I just make a point that, like, there are two Melburnians on this desk and neither of us bragged about that.
No. Off air, been bragging around.
Has anyone spoken to Melton? How does Melton feel about it? They've just been in. Melbourne's just cut like Russia style has come and just taken them. They're going to open up cafes, you know, put laneways down on the streets of Melton.
In Melton.
Because sometimes when you're building an empire, these things have to happen.
Yeah.
What I liked is a couple of people in the audience from Perth. They couldn't care less about this.
They want to secede anyway. They want to start their own country.
Yeah, it's a different country.
Right, you're right.